Okay, you can eat a bunch of supplements to boost your nitric oxide for better erections. But there may be another option. Just eat nothing. In this video, I will explain to you how fasting improves vascular function with the benefit of better erections. I am talking middle-aged to older men here because vascular ED is rarely seen in young men. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist. If this video is not for you, please check out my channel. I have uploaded tons of useful urological information for all age groups. Now, erectile dysfunction is a very common problem in the aging male. ED is the inability to achieve or maintain an erection firm enough for sex. One can say that most men will suffer from erectile issues when they reach a certain age. There are several publications about this, but as a rule of thumb, 40% of the men age 40 and above will have difficulties, and in the age group 70 and above, it's 50 to 100%. Most of this is due to vascular issues. There are two primary mechanisms of vascular aging: endothelial dysfunction and arterial stiffness. Both will eventually result in cardiovascular disease in many people as they age. Erections and the heart are closely linked because both are threatened by the same risk factors. In other words, what's good for the heart is also good for the penis. And as a matter of fact, a sudden onset of erectile dysfunction in a middle-aged man may be a warning sign of an impending heart attack. I know that many of you have learned that nitric oxide is key when it comes to rigid and reliable erections. Nitric oxide is a gas that is released from the endothelium, the inner layer of blood vessels. So when the endothelium is working properly, this will be the foundation of erectile ability. The aging process decreases the amount of available NO. This is the result of two age-related phenomena: rapid degradation of NO on the one hand and less NO production by the endothelium on the other. Let me explain. Within the cells of our body, there are tiny power plants for energy production, the so-called mitochondria. It's like in the real world, energy production goes along with the formation of waste that's not environmentally friendly. In the body, we are talking about reactive oxygen species, superoxide. That stuff is quite aggressive and can cause a lot of damage, which is called oxidative stress. Normally, the body has the means to protect itself from damage. However, during the aging process, these mechanisms no longer work so well, so the oxidative stress increases as we age. Superoxide will also react with nitric oxide to form a secondary free radical, thus reducing NO bioavailability and increasing oxidative stress at the same time. But it gets even worse. Aging goes along with an ever-increasing low-grade state of chronic inflammation of the body. As a result, endothelial function will get worse, and this means less nitric oxide. In reality, it's much more complex than that, but I think you see where this is going. All of this will decrease erectile ability. So, why fasting? What can it do for you? In short, vascular function responds to cellular energy levels. When we fast and the energy level is low, the body has the means to produce energy from using energy depots such as fat. These mechanisms have a huge benefit. They reduce inflammation and oxidative stress. Endothelial function improves and there is more nitric oxide available. We have some studies in humans which show improvements in erectile function in obese men who fasted and lost weight. However, I have to add that much of what we know today still is from animal studies and can't just be translated into humans. But we have similar results from different species, altogether showing effects on longevity from calorie-restricted diets. So possibly, if you eat about 30 to 40% less than your daily demand, you will live longer and have better erections than men in general of your age. Sounds easy? But I'm not sure if this is realistic for most men. Because, I mean, who would want to fast his whole life? Very few, I would guess. And apart from that, Chronic fasting will decrease muscle mass and the bones will not like it either. Resistance training might be able to counteract this, but anyway, we are talking about well-seasoned men, right? So the disadvantages of permanent fasting may outweigh the advantages, but there is a way to combine the best out of two worlds. Intermittent fasting yields the same benefits while avoiding the disadvantages of long-term fasting. There are several regimens how to do it. Maybe the most practical is eating the same amount of calories, but only within a 6 to 12 hour time window and nothing during the rest of the day. Or one could also implement a calorie restriction and only eat every other day or restrict the energy intake to certain days of the week. To see effects, this has to be done over the course of several months. It probably works best in obese men, and please remember, a healthy diet is still key and smoking is an absolute no-go when it comes to improving erectile dysfunction. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.